What's up, beautiful people around the world? Ash Vlogs in the house. I'm actually going to pray Eid Jamaat today in Manchester, Wimslow Road. The reason for being is because I had a pre-booked airport job a couple of weeks ago, so that's why I'm praying at this Wimslow Road. But anyway, masjid is a masjid, wherever you pray, it's the house of Allah. So today we're going to pray at this beautiful masjid, Manchester Wimslow Road. They're actually doing a few jamaat. The first one was at 8, second one is at 9, and the one I'm praying is at 10 o'clock. So let's go and pray Eid Jamaat on Wimslow Road in Manchester with these Muslim brothers. Keep on watching. One of the first things you need to do is before you pray is do wudu, and we're going to do wudu now, and we're going to perform wudu. And it's very important for every single Muslim to do wudu before you pray, otherwise you can't pray, your body is not hot. So let's do wudu and then
Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
So if you come a bit closer inshallah to each other, fill in any gaps. There's plenty more people coming, inshallah. Jazakallah khairan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal mursaleen. Ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah, it's a beautiful sight to see the community together praying outside in the open field. Of course, as we know, this is the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam when it came to the Eid prayer, that he would pray it outside. And alhamdulillah, we've revived it this year. The prayer when it comes to Eid salah is done before the khutbah. Yes, not as we do on Jum'ah. The salah is first. And when it comes to the salah, there are different ways of performing it when it comes to the additional takbirs. We're going to, inshallah, perform it according to the Hanafi madhab, in which there are three additional takbirs in the first rak'ah and three additional takbirs in the second rak'ah. Okay? So in the first rak'ah, we will start with our takbiratul ihram, the normal takbir that we make when we enter into salah. We will recite the thana, and then there will be three additional takbirs. Okay, in which we raise our hands, yeah, for each takbir. And then I will recite Surah Al-Fatiha and Surah Al-A'la. We will then go into ruku', sujood as per normal, and we will stand up for the second rak'ah. In the second rak'ah, I will recite Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Ghashiyah, and then inshaAllah, I will do three additional takbirs before the takbir of going into ruku', inshaAllah. And then we will finish, and then there'll be a short khutbah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this joyous and blessed day of Eid. Eid al-Fitr, as we all know, marks the completion of 30 days or 29 days of fasting. The month of Ramadan is a month in which we've come closer, we've sought to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with this day of Eid as a celebration and as a gift. And through it we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to complete the month of Ramadan. My dear brothers and sisters, in this very short khutbah, I just want to share two points with you. And I want you to reflect with me on these two points. The first one is, why did we fast? Why did we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month of Ramadan? And secondly, what are we going to do moving forward? So firstly, as we all heard at the beginning of Ramadan, that the objective of fasting, the objective of this month is what? Is that we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But just on this one point I want to end, is that as we are celebrating and we are enjoying ourselves and we will be eating today, we should also think about those who are not so fortunate. Those who have been tested and tried in other ways by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wider Muslim ummah. Because as we all know, we are a part of a Muslim ummah. We're not just a community here in Cheedo, but we're a part of a Muslim ummah. And there are Muslim brothers and sisters who will not be celebrating today. who are not going to have the joys that we have today. So we should remember them, we should make dua for them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rectify their affairs and to make things easy for them moving forward. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in concluding this khutbah that He blesses all of us, He blesses our families, He blesses this community, He blesses the Muslim Ummah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts all of the ibadah that we've done in the blessed month of Ramadan. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows us to carry forward some of the actions we started in the month of Ramadan throughout the rest of the months. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله فإنها وصية للأولين والآخرين ولذا قال تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال عيدكم مبارك. I pray you all have a blessed Eid, an Eid Mubarak for myself, my family and the masjid. تقبل الله again. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Guys, so it's back to Sheffield now. The Eid Namaz has been performed. I've prayed it with the fellow Muslim brothers of Cheadle, Wimslow Road. I'll be going back to spend the rest of my day with my family, inshallah, in Sheffield. And because I had a job, pre-booked job, I couldn't pray in Sheffield. But it was different to pray here. As I said, all the masjids around the world are all house of Allah. So wherever you pray, it doesn't matter. As long as you pray somewhere, they're all house of Allah. So let's go back to Sheffield. And it was amazing being here. And on my left hand side, right there back, there was actually all women's sisters praying there. There was at least a good couple of hundred praying there. So I think in different places in England they should do the same thing and have facilities for our sisters to pray as well. The most difficult thing is finding your shoes or your sandals, so you have to remember where you put your shoes and sandals. Luckily I found my sandals. But I've had situations where I've had the same sandals and the same shoes as other people and they've taken it, but I found my sandals anyway. Guys, it's going to be a bit of a mission getting out from this place because all these people are trying to get out at the same time. And it's proper chukka block. Good job, parked my car here. I had one brother approach me from there. He goes, I recognize you. I've seen you before on YouTube. Are you Ash Vlogs? I go, yes, alhamdulillah. A funny story. About a week ago in Sheffield on Carver Street, when I went down the hill, there was a copper. He stopped me and knocked my window. I thought I'm going to be in trouble because I didn't have my seatbelt on, sorry. So he knocked on the door and he goes, same again, Ash Vlogs, I've seen your video, keep it up, awesome. So anyway, this was a day praying at the Wimslow Road Masjid, Cheadle. And it was just amazing to be here and to pray in this fabulous, amazing place. And now everyone's going home. And it was just amazing to be here, but I think it's going to take literally about half an hour for all this to clear. Anyway guys, this is Ash Vlogs. Keep on watching, keep on subscribing, like, comment and share. And inshallah, I will see you in a town near you, inshallah. Eid Mubarak. Assalamu alaikum.